Hi, did you know that you can have your private AI server running on your laptop at home? And the best part, you don't need advanced technical knowledge to do it. In this video, I will show you how to set up a private, local and secure AI server at home using the Ollama in just a few simple steps. Two simple steps to launch the server and another two to work more comfortably. It's completely safe because everything runs locally on your computer. I already set up a server like this at home some time ago. Today I will do it again on my old laptop with Windows. This one. To show you how simple it is. But you can also do this on Linux or macOS. Of course, if you have a more powerful machine, especially with a dedicated GPU, you will be able to run more advanced models and work faster. But for smaller models, a regular laptop will do just fine. Don't worry, I will show you everything step by step from installation to comfortable usage. Ready? Let's go start! Step 1. Install Ollama. First, we need to download and install Ollama. It's an application that allows you to run AI models locally without sending data anywhere else. So, go to ollama.com and download the versions for your system. As you can see, it's available for Linux, macOS and Windows. I'm choosing the Windows version because I use this system on my laptop. The installation process is quick and straightforward. Just a few clicks and you are done. Step 2. Add the Llama 3.2 model. Now it's time to add your first AI model. Go to the models section or the Ollama.com library. It's the same thing. Choose the model you are interested in. I will start with Llama 3.2. Let's talk about tags. The latest tag usually points to the most recent release, which in this case is 3B. However, next time it might point to something else. For simplicity, lower numbers usually mean smaller, simple models, with bigger numbers come bigger models, more complex one. I will go with 3B, which is about 2 GB. To install it, I just copy the command and paste it in terminal. As you can see, it's super simple, no advanced knowledge required. But it can take some time, the download might take a while, so quick coffee break. Okay, the download is complete and that's pretty much. Now you have your AI server. For example, you can write what is AWS. Using a terminal is fine, but you know, it's something better. Let me show you a better way, a graphical interface. Again, just two simple steps. Step 1, install Docker. To make things easier and add graphical interface for managing your AI server, we'll install Docker. Docker is a tool that makes it simple to run various applications in isolated environments. Download the Docker installer from docker.com and install it on your computer. Pick the version from your system. For me, it's the Windows AMD 64 version. The installation process is straightforward, just follow the instruction on the screen. Okay, so restart and short coffee break. Okay, after starting, launch Docker desktop. After a few questions, you should see something like this. If you see this, great. It means everything is working correctly, Docker is up and running and we can move on. If Docker don't start for some reason, pause this video, fix the issue and come back quickly. Step 2. Install OpenWebUI. Okay, now we'll add OpenWebUI, a super simple graphical interface for managing AI server. Go to docs.openwebui.com and follow the instructions. Too excited to wait for your own AI server? If you don't want to read this whole text, just copy the command, paste it in your terminal, and hit enter. This might take some time, so relax and enjoy your coffee. All done. Allow access, and that's it. Open Docker desktop, and you should see a new running container. Perfect. Now just click here or type localhost 3000 in your browser and you are on your private home AI server. Okay, it's worth knowing that you can connect to your personal, private and secure AI server on your local network using your phone or another laptop connected to your Wi-Fi. All you need to do is enter the private IP address of your AI server and add 3000. If you have some technical knowledge, you probably already know this and how to find your server IP address. More important than that, you can set also a static IP, so you can always connect using the same IP address. If you are not familiar with these steps, don't worry, your AI server can guide you on how to set it up. Alright, let's get back to the video. And you are on your private home AI server. Sign in. The first user you create will automatically be the admin. Enter whatever you like. After all, your data stays on your local computer, not on the internet. I will use test lepczynski.it. Click create account and you are ready to go. Now choose a model. As you can see, one we used earlier is available. I love cloud computing, so I will ask what types of load balancer are in AWS. Enter. The response time will depend on your hardware and the complexity of the query. Okay, it works great. But that's not all. For example, copy this and you can ask summarize the following article and paste. If you are a programmer or just getting started with coding, you can ask it to optimize your code. Optimize this code. And paste. Nice. Whoa, it even explains what was improved and why. Yeah, best practices. Nice. Okay, do you have kids? So, this can be helpful. For example, explain Einstein's theory of relativity in simple terms. Like you are talking to a 10 years old. Let's wait a moment. Yeah, nice. Okay, do you want to learn any language? Awesome, try translate this sentence into Spanish and explain the grammar choices. I love learning new things. Awesome. And if we are talking about languages, Llama recognizes commands not just in English. For example, you can write in Polish, write a funny dialogue between a cat and a robot about who is smarter. And the response will be in Polish. Nice. Nice. There is so much I like to show you. For now, we just scratched the surface. We are using one model, but there are many more available. Go to the admin panel, settings, models, and as you can see, there is a huge variety of models. Let's try a bigger one, like 14B. Copy the command. Paste, and you don't even need to use the terminal. It's that easy. Okay, small coffee break. Okay, select new model and ask write Python code to simulate rolling dice. Within a moment, you get a response with ready-to-use code and explanation of how it works. Okay, let's test this. Copy the code. Create a new file. Paste. Save. And run. Python roll dice. Perfect! It works. Again. Whoa. Now let's try a model specialized in images. Do you remember my previous video where we used AWS Lambda to describe images with recognition? Now your local AI server can do the same for free, right from your home. Okay, let's go to Llama 3.2 vision, tags, and let's choose, for example, 11B. Let's copy this. Okay, small coffee break. Okay, new chat. Let's choose Llama 3.2 vision. Now I choose one of my photo, add files, describe this photo. Nice. Or does anyone in this picture wear glasses? It works great. Okay, that's all for today. If you enjoyed this video, smash the like button and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss new content. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.